Hi guys, welcome back. Today we're making sambal, an Indonesian chili paste. For that, we will need dried chilies. You can get them at any Asian supermarket. What you want to do is to remove the seeds. They can be really spicy. So just break them into two. Just tap them lightly. The seeds will fall off. And what you want to do is grind these dried chilies with a bit of water to make it into a chili paste, something like that. Next, we will need some garlic, some salt. You can use jiggery, brown sugar, or normal sugar, and some tamarind. You can use paste or a tamarind seed. It's totally up to you. Then we will mince our garlic. So you can finely chop them or you can use any device that you have at home. We want it to look something like that. Then we will heat up our pan and put some oil. Make sure the oil is sufficient. We'll fry our garlic in it. So just throw your garlic in there, let them fry, but be careful not to burn garlic because they tend to burn really fast. So just put it on a low medium heat, let the garlic do its thing, let them fry until it's golden brown. Then we will add in our chili paste that we made earlier. So just put it in and you know, mix it, make sure it's well combined. I know it looks kind of messy right now, but trust me, over the heat it's going to combine. So the garlic is going to be combined with the chili. So just do that over your medium low heat and just keep turning it until the garlic gets mixed. So it will look something like that. So what you want to do next is to cover it. So once you cover it, let the chili cook, because you want the chili to be cooked, otherwise it's going to be like very spicy kind of chili, which it's not pleasant. So just cover it for 10 minutes, let it do its thing, and after 10 minutes what you want to do is just to move it around. We can add in our sugar. Then we will add in salt. And then finally, we will add in our tamarind water that we made earlier. You can use paste, you can use tamarind seeds, it's totally up to you. So just want to add that. We just want to mix everything together. So just make sure everything is will come together slowly, smoothly. And it's going to be like a loose consistency. And trust me, it will dry up sooner because over the heat, we're going to let it rest. So just combine everything. The tamarind water will get soaked up a bit. So just cover it, let it rest for another 10 minutes. And after 10 minutes, you will notice that it got a bit thicker. So once it's thicker, just move it around. You can notice that it has released some oils. The oils are from the garlic and the chili that we had. You can notice it's not sticking to the pan. It's sliding off, and you can, you know, see the smooth consistency of it. So that's when you know your sambal is done. So what you want to do now is you can transfer it into a bowl or a serving plate, or even put it in a container. You can keep it up to 2 to 3 weeks. So what I'm doing now is to transfer my sambal into a dish. Let it cool down slightly, and I will transfer the sambal into a glass jar. And I will usually keep this, and I will use it for various dishes to make sambal prawn, sambal chicken, fish sambal. It's totally up to you. At this point, this sambal is totally vegetarian. You can customize it however you want. You can add prawn paste, you can add anchovies, anything that you want. So now at this point, we want our sambal to cool down, and then we can transfer it into the jar. Once you transfer it into a jar or a container or anything that you prefer, make sure the sambal is completely cool before you put it in the fridge. And this sambal can last up to 2 to 3 weeks. I mean, in my house, the sambal lasts for a week and then I have to make a new batch. So that's what you want to do. There you have it, your homemade sambal. So do comment below. Let me know how the sambal turned out. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and share.